Okay, folks, okay, we are here in Perfect Body Fitness. I am Hazen Spaden in INM BBTV, and today I'm gonna try to make my body much more perfect again. And for that, I called up my friend Edward Otter. Welcome, my friend. Thank you for the opportunity to be here today, and I'm gonna be under your guidance for training sessions. Come here. So tell me, what are we going to do today?
Okay, today we're going to do some legs exercises. We're going to start with front ties exercise. After that, we're going to do some hamstrings. But first, we're going to start with some warm-up, you know, like some bicycles for 3 to 5 minutes. Mm-hmm. After that, we're going to do some stretching. Then we're going to start with the leg workout.
You said warm-up and stretching. How important is that before start working out?
Avoid injuries on you, you know, because sometimes, you know, for example, you don't train legs every day.
Mm-hmm.
Once or twice a week, so you know, you have to do some stretch, you know, to give the muscles some chance, you know, hey, we're gonna do some workout, we're gonna stretch first, you know, get up the stiffness, as you see, then after that, we're gonna start.
Now, before we start with the fun part, which is the exercises and warming up and stretches, tell us a little bit about yourself. You have bodybuilding experience yourself?
Yeah, I've been in sports for more than 32 years.
32 years?
Yeah, I started first with weightlifting, after that, there's some powerlifting. I won first when I was 15 years old, I won a weightlifting competition.
Okay.
After that, I started with bodybuilding. I started at home, then I went to some other gyms, you know, well-known gyms. I was under the guidance of Nelson Buddha for many years. During that time, I competed, first of all, Mr. Pilosaur Jr. After that, I went to Mr. Hercules. After that, I went to Central Caribbean Championship 2 times. And the last competition I did was the first Mr. Black. After that, you know, I had to stop and went over to coaching people.
So you got
the young guys.
You have quite some legacy.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's a little bit confusing, even for me. What is the difference between powerlifting and weightlifting?
Okay. It's a little bit difficult, but you know, let me explain this to you. I started, you know, in the backyard, you know, we started training, and you know, when you were young, you're 13 years old, you want to live as healthy as possible, you know, just load it up, you know, and you build up the strength, you build up the power, you build up the mental strength. That's the most important thing to us when you start doing those sports, the mental part, you know, and by increasing the weight time by time, day by day, but I was mostly focused on, you know, lifting the weight, go as heavy as possible, you know, and with that, you build up the power, you know, and that was a great part for me, because after that, when I started doing bodybuilding, I had a lot of power, and I used that power, you know, to build up muscles with it, you know.
Yeah.
It came good for me, you know, because I gained a lot of size, you know, in a short period of time, because I was lifting half a year, you know, I could do more weights, I could do more repetitions, you know, that was the part of it that, you know, that helped me a lot.
I see. Now, a lot of people think you just have to, if you want to get a great body, just get in the gym, start working out, and then boom, you have a good body.
No,
is it that way?
No, it's not like that, you know. Most sports, you have to prepare yourself mentally. The most important thing of this is, as you say to those guys, 75% bodybuilding is what you eat. 25% is your workout, you know, your mental part, but the first thought is to say in the kitchen, what do you eat? Do you take a breakfast in the morning, do you eat your lunch? And, you know, that's one of the things that those guys have to start focusing on. What you eat, what time do you eat? Do you take your meals on time, you know, the amount of food that you take in your body, as they say, your intake.
Uh-huh.
Those are the things that you have to focus on, because if you don't do that, forget about it.
Okay. Well, folks, enough of the chit-chat. Let's hit the gym. So where are we going now?
Okay, before we start doing, before we start doing some cardio on the bike,
to warm up,
this is the exercise we're gonna do. When you turn on the bicycle, you stretch, you're gonna start with the leg, with the squat machine. After that, we're gonna do some leg press.
My favorite.
Yeah, we're gonna do some, it's gonna be heavy, we're gonna do some leg press. And when we're done with that, we're gonna do some in thighs. Then after that, leg extension. Close it with the leg curl.
Okay.
Most of the time, when I do front thighs, I don't focus that much on
under the hamstrings.
Because I take hamstrings on a separate day. You know, I keep my legs, you know, between 2 to 3 days rest. Then I'm gonna come back for the hamstring.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
Let's start on the bike.
Let's start.
Yeah. Set it off, set it up. You on the front line, blown and you're getting crushed. We need to bust mind blow with the thick and rust. About to tell your bloodline cold when we interrupt. Set it off, set it up. You on the front line, blown and you're getting crushed. We need to bust mind blow with the thick and rust. About to tell your bloodline cold when we interrupt.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you for the full meal.
It was a pleasure.
And as I say, we are bodybuilders, we are family.
Family. And for you guys out there who's been watching us all along, and anybody out there who wants for us to come to you and get a program like this, film you, you want anything to promote, call us free at 747-737-4606 or like us on Facebook on Incredible Nutrition and More and let us know what you think about our show. And if you want some special diets, go on our website www.inmcur.com, link Dr. Diet. They work. As a spotter, out.